stage the DIVA Jazz Orchestra, Sherrie Maricle, and the concert version of Tapping Through Life, Maurice Hines. We'll be right back.
coming to New York because the audiences talk back to you. Like, welcome to Dizzy's Room. I'm very happy to be here. You know, when I was coming here, I was thinking about when my brother and I were very little, Gregory and I were very little, and we took a picture with Dizzy Gillespie at Birdland many, many years ago. So it's an honor for me to be in a room that's named after Dizzy Gillespie. Honor. It's an honor. And I'm happy to be with my divas. Hello, divas. Hey, baby. She is separate, baby. With those pigtails, she's separate. I'm sorry. I've never been in love before. All at once, it's you, you forevermore. I've never been in love before. I thought my heart was safe. I thought I knew the score. But this is wine. It's all too strange and strong. I'm full of foolish songs. Out my songs must fall. Please forgive this helpless haze I'm in. I've really never been in love before. I've never been in love before. All at once it's you, it's you, it's you forevermore. She was in the new one today. I've never been in love before. I thought my heart was safe. I thought I knew the score. But this is wine. It's all too strange and strong. I'm full of foolish songs. Out my songs, well, they're gonna pour, baby. Please forgive me. Help me say I've been up. I've really never been in love before. Take some, baby. Take some. To walk us up Lenox Avenue in Harlem to 125th Street to go play in the park. And as we were walking up Lenox Avenue, people would run out of stores. They'd go, here they come, here they come. She said, I think they're talking about my babies. She said, so she went home, she told Danny. Danny said, well, listen, just cause you think they're cute, you think everybody thinks they're cute. She said, well, I'll tell you what, you come with us tomorrow and see what happens. Same thing happened. He says, I don't get it, they're just walking. Well, you know, she said, you know how it is when you play Count Basie on the Victrola. Remember when he used to call record players Victrolas? Don't act like you all don't know that now. She said, you know how it is, they jump around? He said, all kids jump around when they hear music. She said, yeah, but our sons jump to the beat. Maybe they're gonna be dancers. My mother was always thinking ahead, see? She said, you know what we should do? We should bring them to the Apollo Theater. Count Basie's there right now, and you know, they always have a dance team to open the show, and of course they did. It was the Clark Brothers. But I gotta tell you, I really only remember the singer with the Count Basie band. There was only one. His name was Joe Williams. Yeah, he walked into that stage, baby. You know what he said? He looked at the audience. This is exactly what he said. He said, every day I have the blues. That's what Joe said. Every day I have the blues. Well, nobody loves me. Nobody seems to care, those divas know. I said that nobody loves me. Nobody seems to care. When it comes to trouble, baby, you know I'll have my share. You see, I'm gonna pack my suitcase, move on down the line. I'm gonna pack my suitcase, move on down the line, yes. Ain't nobody worried, you know divas, ain't nobody crying, yeah. Seems to me every day, have the blues, have those blues, most every day, I have the blues, have the blues, most every day, I have the blues, take it away. When my brother Gregory and I were very, very little, something traumatic happened to us, and we heard our parents arguing for the very first time. That was traumatic for any child. But at 3 and 5, it was traumatic. It was traumatic, right, divas?
Oh,
yeah. And I'll set the scene for you. In fact, mother was in the kitchen. She was making dinner, and she was making mashed potatoes when they really made mashed potatoes. Daddy came from the back bedroom. He said, listen, I've had it. I'm gonna take a walk and cool off. And of course, Gregory and I were scared. The daddy was screaming and yelling, slamming doors, right? Mother came out the kitchen. She said, listen, sons, don't worry about a thing. Because when a man says he's gonna take a walk to cool off, that's cause he knows he's wrong. All the ladies know that. All of a sudden, the key was back on the door. Of course, we were excited to see daddy coming back, and He was cool. But mother, she knew he was coming back. So here's what happened. She stayed in the kitchen, and this is daddy. Daddy had a good rap. Now daddy could talk his talk. He could talk his talk, Divas. So he gets to the kitchen door. This is exactly what he said to her. I've grown accustomed to your face. It truly makes my day begin. I've grown accustomed to the tune. You whistle night and noon. Your smiles, your frowns, your ups, your downs. They're second nature to me now. She turned around, she turned around, she was looking at him. Like breathing out and breathing in, she started walking towards him. Then he made a mistake, he said. I was serenely independent and content before we met. She went right back to the mashed potatoes. Surely, I could always be that way again. And yet, I've grown accustomed to your looks, baby. Accustomed to your voice. Accustomed to your face. He put his hand out. She took it. And they began to dance. I've grown accustomed to your face. It truly makes my day begin. I've grown accustomed to the tune. You whistle night and noon. Your smiles, your frowns, your ups and your downs. They're second nature to me now. Like breathing out and breathing in. I was serenely independent and content before we met. Surely I could always be that way again. And yet I've grown accustomed to your looks. I've grown accustomed to your voice, accustomed to your face. And then they kissed, and Gregory and I looked at each other, and we went, yeah. True story, true story. Now, around this time, around the same time, Gregory and I, we were doing our very first television show. We were 7 and 5. And years ago, they had these kiddie shows, these talent shows on Metro Media, Channel 5 here in New York. And we were on our way to our very first one. Right? We're all dressed up and everything. We get to the studio, and Mother says, okay, where are my babies performing? Where are my babies performing? Right over there. Gregory and I get in our spot. Let's say, she's okay, where's the drummer? My sons need a beat. They have to have a beat now. She said, Mrs. Hines, it's a local show, Channel 5. We ain't got no money. So I'll tell you what. You got a piano player? I'll work with the piano player. She said, piano player, give me this. Junga, 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 junga. My mother was big on the junga jungas. All right. So here's the very first number Gregory and I ever did together. First you put your two knees close up tight. You swing them to the left. You swing them to the right. You step around the floor, kind of nice and light. A bang, a twist around with all of your might. Spread your loving arms way out in space. You do the eagle rock with the silent grace. You put your left foot out, you bring it back. But that's what we call balling the jack. Now, as luck would have it, a CBS executive sees us on this little kiddie show. And says, oh my goodness, these two guys would be wonderful on the Jackie Gleason show, which was a big show at the time. In fact, Jack Benny is coming on next week, and we'll do a talent contest. They'll do Ball in the Jack, he'll do Love and Bloom on the violin, and then they'll do a contest, and the boys will win, and he'll do a Jack Benny take. Right, so we do that, and Jack Benny, of course, we win the contest, right? So we get behind the curtain. Jack Benny is looking at us, and Jackie Gleason says, ladies and gentlemen, the little Hines kids. So here's what we did. Here's what. First you put your two knees close up tight. You swing them to the left. You swing them to the right. You set them up the floor. I said, like a thing you twist to me. Bring it back. That's what we call Jack. And of course, we won the contest. Jack Benny gave his great famous take. But when we were on the show, somebody sees us on the show, as luck would have it again, books Gregory and I for tapping all the way. All the way to Las Vegas, Nevada. We were 75. We were so excited. We said, Mother, we're going to be playing in Las Vegas, Nevada. We can't believe it. She said, oh, well, it's going to be a wonderful time. You're going to have a great time. And so we get in the airplane. And we're arriving at night. And in those days, the airport was close to the hotels, so we could see the hotels as we were arriving. So we look out the window. Mother, look, there's the famous strip, Las Vegas. Oh, my goodness. She smiled. She didn't say nothing. Okay, we get down there. We get into the cab. Now, Gregory and I just know we are driving towards those lights. Oh, no. We started driving into the dark. And out of the darkness came a brand new hotel, 1955. It was called the Moulin Rouge. It was the very first integrated hotel in Las Vegas history. But it wasn't the strip. And Gregory and I, you know how kids are. We get to the lobby and we say, Mother, we are not supposed to be here. We're supposed to be on the strip. That's where we're supposed to. And you know how mothers are. Don't you embarrass me in this lobby. Understand what I'm telling you? All right. Now, we're getting ready to do this wonderful show, and this show was fabulous, too. It was an all-black review called Hot Brown and Beige, baby. Oh, yes, and the chorus girls, they were not skinny like they are today. No, no, no. They were stacked up. Pow, 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 pow. They were all built like Nicki Minaj, so you know what I'm talking about. Okay. So we're doing three shows a night. Now, the strip is doing two. So all the great stars came to see us. Oh, we met Marlena Dietrich, and we met Harry Belafonte, Nat King Cole. And one night, this great movie star at the time came in to see the show. Her name was Tallulah Bankhead. She comes in, she sees the show. She sees us. You two kids are wonderful. I gotta do stuff for you. In fact, I'm appearing on the strip. You'll come tomorrow afternoon, we'll have lunch, and you'll meet my best girlfriend, Pearl Bailey. Right? So we're excited to meet Pearl. Now, we know we ain't supposed to be on that side of town, but Mother said it's okay because it's Tallulah and Pearl. We get over there. We're having lunch. We meet Pearl Bailey, fabulous woman, fabulous entertainer. And then all of a sudden, the lifeguard comes over and said, listen, guys, these two little fellas cannot go in the water. Tallulah Bankhead said, what are you talking about? I am Tallulah Bankhead, and if they don't go in that water, I'm not going on tonight. Well, we went in the water. We're swimming around. Now, we don't notice people are getting out the water. We don't notice this, because we're little kids. All of a sudden, we get out the water, and they drain the pool. Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by. If you smile through your tears and sorrow, smile and maybe tomorrow, you'll see the sun come shining through for you. Just light up your face with gladness, hide every trace of sadness. Although a tear may be ever so near, that's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just smile. Of your face with gladness, high trace of sadness, although a tear it may be ever so near. That's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? One of the great stars that we couldn't see because we couldn't go to that part of town later became a great friend of mine. I was starring in Sophisticated Ladies on Broadway, and she was starring in her one-woman show, Knocking 'Em Dead. I'm talking about the fabulous, and I'm going to say it again, fabulous, Miss Lena Hall. And we became great friends, and one day I went to her dressing room and said, "Hey, Lena, one day I'm going to do a tribute to you in my show." She said, "Yeah, you're going to do a tribute to Lena, baby?" I said, "Yeah." Well, she said, "Hines, what you going to do?" I said, "I'm going to do that song you do with your great bass player, George Vivier." She said, "Well, you better get yourself a great bass player because it's just you and them." Well, I want you to meet my great bass player to do this tribute to Lena. Please help me welcome Miss Amy Shook. Get this out your way, baby. Get this out your way. All right, get it out of Amy Shook's way because she's going to shook up the bass. 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 Put it right here. Now, Amy plays what we call in the business nasty bass. Every honeybee fills with jealousy when they see you out with me. I don't blame them, goodness knows. Ooh. Honeysuckle, she got nasty already. Honeysuckle rose. When you're passing by, flowers droop and sigh. And I know the reasons why. You're my sweeter, goodness knows. Honeysuckle rose. Well, I don't buy sugar. You just have to touch my cup. You're my sugar. Look out now. Sweet when you stir it up. When I'm taking sips, tasty lips, seems the honey fairly drips. Honeysuckle rose. Take some, mama. Take some, take some, take some, take some. Take some. Nasty, nasty on that bass. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Amy Shook on bass, ladies and gentlemen. Amy, Amy, fill with jealousy when they see you out with me. I don't blame them, goodness knows. Honeysuckle rose, honeysuckle rose. When your best sent by flowers droop side. Take it, mama. When I'm taking sips from your tasty lips, the honey fairly drips. The more confection, those lips are good too, baby. You are the confection. Goodness knows. Honey, honey, say I come around. Miss Amy Shook, ladies and gentlemen. She can slap that bass, slap that bass! I love singing with her, I love it. Well, I'm sure a lot of you remember that theme song, because that's the original theme song for The Tonight Show starring the great Johnny Carson. Now, by this time, the little Hines kids had morphed into this act called Hines, Hines and Dan. My father joined Gregory and I, and we were working a lot. And in fact, we were working in Chicago at the Playboy Club. Years ago, the Playboy magazine had all these clubs all over the country. You could make a good living. And we were at the main one in Chicago. And down the block, Johnny Carson was appearing at the Auditorium Theater. And he comes to the club one night, he sees us. He said, "You guys are wonderful. I'm gonna put you on my show." Now, Gregory and I just looked at each other because you see, we had already failed 7 auditions for his show. But we figured once he found that out, you know, no, not Johnny. No, he was true to his word, and he brought us on the show, and the last 5 years he was in New York City, before he moved the show to Los Angeles, he had us on the show 37 times. No doubt about it. He was a wonderful man. Made us. And so while we were working with him, while we were doing the show, Daddy comes home one night, he said, "Guys, guess what? A lady saw us on Johnny's show and wants us to open for her in Las Vegas at the Flamingo on the Strip." We said, "Daddy, we ain't supposed to be on the Strip." He said, I know, but this woman this one lady told the hotel what to do and they did it." He said, "Yes." I said, "Well, who is this woman? Because she got to have a lot of power." He said, "She does." I said, "Well, who is it, Daddy?" He said, "Ella Fitzgerald." So we're working with Ella, loving every minute of it, because she was not only one of the great singers of all time, she was great in here, sweet as can be. And while we're working with her, something historic happened. It had never happened before. It's never happened again. Every single showroom on the Strip was starring an African-American star. I mean, the man upstairs did that. There was Harry Belafonte, Nat King Cole, the Mills Brothers, Nancy Wilson. It was wonderful. And then Sammy, who we knew from New York, says, "Guys, listen, I know you're closing tomorrow night, but you're going to stay over a few days because there's a guy in my show at the Sands wants to meet you because you're working with the First Lady of Song." We said, "Well, who is this man that wants to meet? And you got to come before the show. Not after, like you come after we do." "No." I said, "This man wants to meet us before he does anything?" He said, "Yeah." I said, well, Sammy, who is it?" He said, "Frank Sinatra." Oh, my God. Oh, my goodness. Frank Sinatra. Oh, my God. I'll set the scene. When Sammy Davis drew his dress group, having a wonderful time, laughing and joking with his lovely wife, Mai Britt, his conductor, George Rhodes, all of a sudden the door opens, and there is Frank Sinatra, looking like Frank Sinatra. He walked in, he owned that city, he said, welcome to Las Vegas, welcome. So wonderful, you know, we can't believe we're looking at Frank Sinatra. All of a sudden, the door opens again, and it's Dean Martin. Oh my God, I'm in this business a long time, I ain't never met nobody cooler than Dean Martin. I mean, Jay-Z and P. Diddy think they're cool. They're not cool, I'm telling you. He's standing there with a shot glass, looking cool as can be. He said, "You guys gonna see the show?" We said, "Yes, Mr. Martin, yes." He said, "Go out and have a good time." So we're sitting ringside. Sammy Davis comes out, does a couple of numbers. He says, "Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to meet my best friend, Mr. Frank Sinatra." Sinatra walked on the stage. I've never seen that kind of charisma. I mean, it's unbelievable. With the blue eyes and so thin, you know, wonderful. He looks at the audience. This is exactly what he says to them. He says this. This is exactly what he says to them. "Come fly with me. Let's fly away. Well, if you could use some exotic booze, there's a bar in Bombay. Fly with me, let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float up to Peru. Well, in Lava Land, there's a one-man band. Toot, 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 for you. Fly with me, let's float off to the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide, starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll me holding you so near. Hey, baby, you might hear other angels sing just because we're together. But oh, it's such a lovely day. Just say a word, I'll meet the birds down to Acapulco. If it's real, when somebody needs you, it's no good unless they need you all the way through the good old lean years and for all the in-between years, come what may. Well, who knows where the road will lead us? Only a fool would say, but if you let me love you, it's for sure I'm gonna love you all the way, all the one, two, one, two, three, four. To do something. I can feel it. Baritone sax is revving up, baby. She's revving up. Divas. Divas, I like y'all. You know where? Under my skin. Under my skin. You can't beat Sinatra. They call you Lady Luck, but there is room for doubt. At times you have a very unladylike way of running out. You're on this date with me. The pickings have been lush. And yet before this evening is over, you might give me the brush. Well, you might forget your manners. You might refuse to stay. So the best that I can do is pray. Recorded from that great musical, Guys and Dolls. Luck be your lady tonight. Luck be my lady tonight. Luck, if you've ever been a lady to begin with. Luck be your lady tonight. Luck, let a gentleman see a dame you can be. Well, I've seen the way you've treated other guys you've been with. Luck be a lady with me. A lady doesn't leave her escort. It isn't fair. It isn't nice. Well, a lady doesn't wander all over the room and blow on some other guy's dice. Let's keep the party polite. Never get out of my sight. Ha! Stick with me, baby. I'm the fella you got in with. Look, be a lady tonight. Gentlemen, see how nice a dame you can be. Well, I've seen the way you've treated other guys you've been with. A lady does not leave her escort. It isn't fair. It ain't nice. Well, a lady doesn't wander all over that room and blow on some other guy's dice. Ah! Let's keep the party polite. Never, never get out of my sight. Ha! Step with me, baby. I'm the fella you got it with. I'm not feeling. Come on! You know, we just finished doing our show in Philadelphia for 8 weeks. And one day I was coming into the theater for the matinee, and the band was just jamming. They were just jamming. So I said, we got to put this in the show, because they were just cooking. So I want you to hear what they could do. You all ready to jam?
Ready.
You ready? I know, you ready, Sherrie?
Ready.
You ready, baby? Okay. You ready, Jackie? The pigtails are working. The pigtails are working. Okay, here we go. Hit it. Thank you. Sherrie Maricle on drums, ladies and gentlemen. Jackie on piano. Working the pigtails, baby. She's working the pigtails. And DIVA. Okay, I feel like tapping. Put it right here. This is a song that I did on Broadway for about a year. But Gregory did it also for about a year. And he went to LA with it too. I always pay tribute to the man that gave us our third act of our careers. You all know who that is. The great Duke Ellington and the great musical sophisticated ladies. So I'm gonna sing this song. You're gonna help me out in this. I'll show you where you're gonna come in. Well, I don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. You know what to do. Do what, do what, do what, do what, do what, do what, do all right, New York. It don't mean a thing. All you got to do is sing. Come on, y'all. Do what, 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 do what. Well, it makes no difference if it's sweet or hot. You got to give that rhythm everything. You got to shove it at the don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. One last time, come on. The show that we do usually is called Maurice Hines is Tapping Through Life, and we have pictures of my brother and myself and my mother and father and all the great people that we were very fortunate to work with, like Judy Garland and Sammy, of course. But at the end of the show, there's a picture of my mother when she was 16, because she got us through some hard times in this business. Hard times. Oh, baby. And my mother saw us through all those hard times. So I always sing this song to her, this last song. She was 16, didn't know what her life was going to be like. Met my father and had these two sons who completely adored her. And the picture's up there. You can't see it now because it ain't there. It ain't there because it ain't there. I don't know what I'm talking about. You're just, am I in the right key? Wait. You're just too marvelous for words, like glorious and glamorous, and that old standby amorous. You're just too wonderful. I'll never find the words that say enough, that can tell enough. You know, they just aren't swell enough. Mother, you're much too much. You're just too very, very to ever be in Webster's dictionary. And so I'm borrowing a love song from the birds, to tell you that you're marvelous, too marvelous for words. Now I'm gonna sing it to y'all, because you've been wonderful coming out of this nasty night to see the show. You're just too marvelous for words, like glorious, glamorous, that'll stand by amorous. You're just too wonderful. I am searching for the words that can say enough, tell enough. You know, they just aren't swell enough. People, you're much too much. You're just too very, to ever be in Webster's dictionary. And so I'm borrowing a love song from the birds. I'll tell you that you all have been marvelous. Oh, too marvelous for words. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me thank the fabulous DIVA Orchestra under the direction of Miss Sherrie Maricle on drums. Aren't they fabulous and gorgeous? Gorgeous and fabulous. Fabulous and gorgeous. You're much too much. You're just too very, very to ever be in Webster's dictionary.